For over 20 years, Korean cinema stood for great cinema and high-quality productions, even though the budgets are nowhere near those of Hollywood. Nevertheless, films from the Asian peninsula very often manage to outshine Western productions. The show Squid Game is currently causing a sensation worldwide, but of course the success of Parasite at the Oscars in 2020 put Korean cinema even more in the spotlight. But Asian films, not only from South Korea but also from Japan or Hong Kong, still have the stigma of being very wack, over the top, crazy and also strange. Yet there are even North American and European films that are all like this. And it's mostly just the cultural differences and the behaviors that seem strange. But if you can look past that, get into it and accept it, then you have to realize that South Korean cinema has produced a lot of high quality films in the last 20 years. But if you ask yourself as a film fan, where do I start or which films should I watch first, then I have some films for you, sorted by genre, which you can watch as a beginner in the Korean film world without any problems. Oh yeah, regarding subtitles. Here in Germany, almost 95% of all movies and series are dubbed and in good quality. Since this is not the case in other countries, you have to ask yourself, why domestic animated movies and cartoons were dubbed well? But anyway, let's start. Snowpiercer. You can't go wrong with Snowpiercer at first. The cast is mostly made up of Western actors, but the entire production is from the hands of the South Koreans. Hong Kyung-pyo's cinematography and Bong Joon-ho's direction are stunning and are a treat for any film fan who likes sci-fi action movies. The scenario with a train traveling through the icy world with the rest of humanity on it was visually realized in a great way, and each train compartment holds its own life and it stays exciting until the end, because you don't know what is behind the next compartment. Deliver Us From Evil. An entertaining action film with two great main leads who play a thrilling game of cat and mouse. Not a new story, but an interesting one with an exotic setting in Bangkok. Great choreographed action scenes were captured with equally great cinematography. Hong Kyung-pyo's at its finest. For the main part of the handmade action scenes, the main actors did their own stunts. Oh, and Lee Jung-jae in a great role and a totally different appearance than in Squid Game. The Man From Nowhere. A taciturn but likable main character becomes the focus of a criminal gang through no fault of his own, but his mysterious past comes to light. You can call him the South Korean John Wick before there even was a John Wick. This action film also convinces with super filmed action scenes and great fight choreography, especially the knife fight at the end. The story is basic, but it has emotional moments which underline the main character and his actions. Burning. A first-class mystery drama in which the main character goes in search of his friend who just disappeared without a trace. His suspicion falls on Ben, whom his friend just met recently. Thanks to Lee Jung-dong's excellent directing and Hong Kyung-pyo's brilliant and atmospheric cinematography, these 2.5 hours don't become boring at any minute. This is also thanks to the three main actors, Yoo Ah-in, Jeon Jong-seo and Steven Yeun. All three have a super dynamic chemistry with each other and pull off a great performance. For fans of other mystery dramas such as Disturbia, Rear Window or Mystic River. Parasite. Much discussed and talked about and award-winning. Of course, also a good starting point to familiarize yourself with South Korean cinema. Hong Kyung-pyo's cinematography and Bong Joon-ho's directing are great and the cast delivers solid performances. The Handmaiden. An erotic drama set during the time of the occupation of Korea by Japan. A pickpocket poses as a maid to try to seduce the mistress of the house together with the con artist and to seize her money and wealth. What sounds like a shallow and simple drama turns out to be a real visual eye-catcher, with many twists and turns that even amaze on the third rewatch. The story has been brilliantly realized and Park Chan-wook's direction is a delight. The scenery, the set and costume design are amazingly crafted. Hey Taxi Driver. A historical drama that really gets to your heart. A cab driver takes a German journalist to Gwangju to report on the military coup and student uprisings. Very emotional and a good example of what South Korean drama has to offer in terms of depth and quality. At no time does it get boring and after arriving in Gwangju, you feel for everyone involved and hope for a positive outcome. Song Kang-ho, who plays the cab driver, delivers one of his best performances. In the beginning, he is a simple-minded and oddball cab driver who talks a lot and only looks out for himself, and later he is totally emotionally affected by the events and helps the journalist to report about the grievances to the world. Ta-e-guki, aka Brotherhood, aka Brotherhood of War. A war drama set during the Korean War in the 50s. Two brothers are conscripted by the military to fight in the war. In order to save his younger brother from the fighting and from the battlefield, the older brother accepts extremely dangerous assignments in which he repeatedly puts his life on the line. The combination of a relentless war film and an emotional drama make this film a must-watch for fans of war dramas. The war scenes are harsh and ruthless, and the film takes its time to present its characters properly and does not avoid emotional scenes. Call. An atmospheric horror film in which the two main characters communicate via a mysterious phone connection and realize that they live 20 years apart and can influence the future with a disturbing outcome. What starts as a small innocent mystery drama later unfolds as a serious psycho horror film. The atmosphere that director Lee Chung-hyun captures is a delight and can make any horror fan happy. Train to Busan. Already a zombie classic. The mix of zombie horror and emotional drama gives this film a unique selling point that can't be topped anytime soon. Director Sang-ho Yoon gives this film a life of its own that keeps you intrigued until the end. The makeup effects are great and the zombies are everything you want in zombies. They are fast, sensitive to sound, transform quickly and look disgusting. The precursor to all subsequent zombie films from the Korean Peninsula. If you like Dawn of the Dead, you enjoy this one too. Hashtag Alive. Hashtag Alive continues the South Korean zombie traits. Again, they are fast as hell, extremely sensitive to noise, and look totally disgusting. The makeup effects are great as well. Story-wise, you are trapped in a building complex with the main character, who tries to survive during the pandemic. The only cons are for the ending. Il Mare. The oldest entry on this list. Il Mare is a lovable and very well-told romantic drama for which cinematography Hong Kyung-pyo once again is responsible. The film doesn't drift into any clichés and has two incredibly likable main characters, with Jun Ji-hyun and the young Lee Jung-jae. A remake starring Sandra Bullock and Keanu Reeves was also released in 2006. I Saw the Devil. Personally, one of my all-time favorites. A story told a little differently about revenge and the abyss you get into when you go for it. I Saw the Devil is a dark psychological thriller with an intense cat-and-mouse game. A Korean secret agent sets out to hunt down his fiancé's killer. He catches him over and over again only to inflict pain to him and then let him go. Again and again and again. But with this, he descends more and more into the dark abyss and his counterpart is not someone to be underestimated. Director Kim Jae-won's masterpiece. The atmosphere captured throughout the film is dark, cold, melancholic and sad. The film also doesn't hold back with violent scenes. So much so, in fact, that it had to be recut even for the Korean release. Lee Byung-hun and Choi Min-sik deliver amazing performances. Old Boy. The second part of Park Chan-wook's Revenge trilogy. Another one of my all-time favorites and the one that was the first Korean movie experience for me as well. South Korean heavyweight Choi Min-sik is imprisoned for 15 years without knowing why. When he is released, he has to find out why they did this to him. At the first watch, everything may seem strange, but in the end, everything will be cleared up with a twist that is nevertheless very disturbing. A twist with a high rewatch potential, and even without it, you can watch the whole movie again and again. Because director Park Chan-wook has created a modern classic of Korean cinema with Old Boy. He captures so much melancholy and suspenseful atmosphere, nur am Ende dann voll auf die Kacke zu hauen. Memoir of a Murderer. The final entry, a thriller recommendation about a former serial killer who suffers from Alzheimer's disease. When murders start happening again, he tries to record his memories and thoughts with the help of an audio diary. An unconventional thriller and drama that features a great main character and great storytelling. At every turn, you can expect a new twist and until the end, you are left guessing who the real killer is. Great acting, a terrific directional performance and superb cinematography gives this film a unique atmosphere. A small little diamond in the big Korean sea of cinema. I highly recommend the director's cut. That's it for this video. If you enjoyed this kind of video, please leave a like, a comment and subscribe for more. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time, have an awesome day.